Hi everybody. It's almost lunchtime here and I decided I better do a little video. I've been kind of absent, busy doing all those things that need done, as I'm sure you are very busy too. And I want to discuss a few things about watering and humidity and pots and your area. And here in Salmon Arm, our humidity outside today, because we had a slight rain, which we haven't had for a few days, our humidity in the house was down around 40%, because we had like summer weather for a week or two, probably a couple weeks at least. And most of the orchids that are non-bloom are out in the patio. And we're going to talk about your humidity in your area and your watering practices. So we always hear the story, over watering kills more orchids than any other thing. So why is this? Why is this happening? And there's probably a multitude of reasons. And once you sort out the humidity in your area, in your house, where your orchids are, you can decide on the proper media and the watering practices. And here, I don't think it's often that our humidity drops below 40. And it quite often can be in up to 70, 80, I think they even say 90 sometimes, and probably the odd time it might drop below 40, but quite often in the house, because I keep little humidifier registers so I know approximately what it is. And if it's been really dry, like it was running in the low 40s here, then you have to increase your humidity. So how I do that is, of course, my humidity bowls that we know about, which is misting. And you can also buy small misters that will do the same thing and take up less space. And some people use trays with beads or rocks and sit their pots on that. Anything where the water will evaporate around your plant to increase the humidity on days when it's just not up to par, because they like to be about 50 to 80% humidity. And I'm always running a little low, I have to tell you. So when you group your orchids together, if you're in a home environment where your humidity is always on the drier side, if you keep your orchids like in a kitchen or a bathroom, there's a lot more humidity because of the cooking and the running water, and that also helps. So if it's been dry a long time and your orchids are near a window and you have a bit of rain, just open a window near where your orchids are and let them get some of that fresh humidity from outdoors. That's also good for them. And I also have some bowls, they're just colorful, but I have a little extra water sitting around here right now, because most of my misters are out in the patio now. So I just take some bowls, I sit some water in them, and then they can, that also adds to the humidity. So today, with a slight rain outside, you can see we're running at about 50, and the temperature is about 70. Now, this is cool. Everybody's going, oh, this is cool. We had summer and spring, and now summer's coming. We're probably going to get spring and summer. So, first, we'll deal with the people like me that we're heading into summer. We're in late spring now, and what should you do for your watering practices? So what happens in the spring is there's a lot more light, especially if you're near a window or you put them out in your patio. We have more varying of temperatures. We have the temperature rising way up and then cooling off at night. We've been quite cool here at night. And I think about it's going to the 50s and you don't like them to get any cooler than that because they could have a real shock and it wouldn't take long for the leaves to just rot away if it was real cold. So mine are protected near the house in the east corner of a patio, so they're more protected, so I don't worry about them. I put them out there and they're out there now till October. So what happens is you've had your watering practices and maybe all winter you've been watering once a week. You have bark, and if you check down, and I'd say always do this, if you're curious, if you're not getting enough water, dig down into your bark, see how dry the roots look, see how dry the bark is, and if you just squeeze it, you might feel a little dampness, and if it's really dry, then you know you have to water. And you should not have to water more than a couple days of the week, even in the summer. The Phalaenopsis orchid only has two ways to hold on to moisture, and one is their roots and one is their leaves. And if you water too much, those roots swell up and they won't absorb anymore. They can only absorb too much. In fact, say when you're fertilizing, there's actually quite a big argument about fertilizing when it's doing the most good. So if you have a big pot with a few drops of your fertilizer in, like today I watered the ones inside because I'm busy tomorrow, so I did it today. And I filled up my sink, which is about 4 to 5 gallons of water. I put 4 drops of the higher middle number because these are all the flowers that are in spike at the moment. So I give them more, and they need this now because there's more light coming, there's changing temperatures, and all this is signaling your orchids to grow. So now you'll see new leaves coming, new roots coming. So the more light they're getting and the more change in the weather, the warmer days are all signaling them to grow. And when they're growing more so than resting over the winter, then they need a little more fertilizer and a little more water. But I don't want you water too much. And that's why I say check your bark. Because sometimes you think they drying out, or you see signs like some of my newer ones that I just potted in the last video, some of their leaves did go a little limp, and one I cut the spike off, and that was all. That was in one that was just compacted because there was no breathing holes in that pot. There was no air. Those roots need air. They need air for oxygen to do their photosynthesis properly. They need air. And if you're always keeping that wet, they're not gonna get the air. And this is why I like bark. I like bark because it's free draining. You can water it, you can soak it for 5 or 10 minutes, and the water will just wash out when you lift your pot up. So you know that that's come out, but right now after doing that, that bark is going to get very humid and stay that way for a few days. Now, This is why we soak the bark for 24 hours before we do it, because new bark takes a while to really hold on to that humidity. So when your orchid is changing from, say, moss to bark, then it's already, it is a shock to it, but it's a shock it will get over it with and be happier. So patience is really important at this time. So we know the bark is not really holding on to as much moisture, but that does not mean you have to give it more water. Misting the top of your plant, your aerial roots, even if you want to do it daily, is better than watering, say, more than twice a week. So, like I'm doing now, the growth is saying I need more fertilizer, I need more water. That doesn't mean more fertilizer. Still a weak solution of fertilizer in your water. Soak it for 5 or 10 minutes and get it out. And there, that's a good watering. I do a real good watering one day a week. Now, the ones that are out in the patio are drying out a lot quicker. So I have all my humidity bowls and I have a fan going, because it gets very hot in the glassed insularium, over 90 even now. And air movement's also important at this time. So the second watering I do, and we're talking about the humidity in this area. The second watering I do, I just have my watering can and I pour it around the outside of the plant, maybe one trip or two trips around, let it run through, and I have all my pots sit on an upside down bowl or a piece of anything that raises it above the water. I let the water on the patio run down into the bowl, so it's only adding higher humidity for your plants. As the air gets to it, it comes up and whatever it does. I'm sorry. What is that word? That's the trouble of talking to you this way, and you can't tell me what word I'm thinking of. Anyway, so this is in our area, and this is what I do. So the misting, humidity, and what else have I noticed to do with controlling humidity for your pots? Well, the bigger pots, now, I feel like every time I show this orchid, it's like they're not going to believe it's real. This has been since the end of December. In the middle of December, it was getting its buds. It has no, it's not showing any signs of doing anything different. And I'm really looking forward to this being still going on my birthday. Like, I'll have to give it some kind of award or special treatment, because it's coming soon and it's beautiful. But okay, I have noticed the bigger pots, and I know a lot of places say small pots, they love to be cuddled in small pots. That is not true, I'm telling you. The road cone, the big road cone, that is so healthy. When they are in a bigger pot, they spend more time at first growing healthier, strong, and more roots in the pot. So here we are. anyway, yes, it's real. And can you believe it, how long this has been flowering? So it's in a bigger pot. Now, moon glow. Hey, don't want to break that. Moon glow, of course, she had her keiki, which is in the pot now. I tried a couple different things, and I've decided she definitely looks happier in the pot with her mom. And the keiki had a spike, which I cut off some time ago. And the mother has lost a couple. This has been since December. She's lost a couple, but she's still holding on. So what beautiful, beautiful flowers since all that time. Now, this one here, this one is also in a bigger pot. I like this size pot. This is a real nice size pot. Now, this is one you buy. I probably picked it up really cheap somewhere. So this is the one I thought was going to die on me. And it lost all but two leaves. And it's not dead. It's beautiful. And we'll see how long. But yes, it's still dripping a bit because I watered it. And as your bark gets a little bit older, you know, maybe 6 months or so, you'll find it will hold the humidity, help keep your humidity level a lot better. But the smaller pots, you may find to have to water them a little extra. They're smaller, they have lots of holes, and they're going to dry out quicker. And that decision you can make on your own. But always remember, you want that media to be, to just start to dry out before you water. They need that dry time for the oxygen to do its job. So, bigger pots will help you keep the humidity level up in your pot and less watering. Now, I like lots of air holes because very important to have drainage and air supply. I like lots of holes. You can see this white one when I did the garden top for Salmon Arm. That was in bloom. It still has one spike. It's in a big pot. It's happy. It's healthy. So I do have some in small pots. Now this is one that my mom picked out in the last video. It's a smaller pot, and if it looks real dry, and I dig down in here and take off some bark until I get maybe 2 inches down into the pot. If it looks real dry, I will water it again, but I will make sure that it's getting dry. It didn't lose any flowers, it's getting new ones, and it's doing fine. So, I have found, usually it's when it's been in the moss a long time and there's been more damage done to the roots that you run into problems with flowers dropping. Or really, if you're keeping it in the same room that you had it before, nothing's changing temperature-wise, I think that you should be fine. So, So this is the humidity for my area and how I do it. I do not add any extra moss on the top. A top dressing, if you're worried about the humidity, the pots drying out too fast, or if you have smaller pots, you could put a top dressing of moss or something else that you think is suitable. I don't do that because, and I don't put any moss in my bark because I don't need it, and I don't want to repot. I want them to stay. It's bigger chunks of bark. I may not repot for 3 years, maybe 2 years, maybe longer. It'll depend, because the smaller the pieces of bark, and moss is going to go acidic and have to be changed once a year, for sure. If you don't mind doing that, then a little extra moss if you're worried about dryness, but you don't want it so it's always surrounding the roots and the roots are not getting air. And this is why I don't do it. I've been happy with the bark. You can see the plants are happy. It's not their ideal condition. It's a house. In the winter we have heat, in the summer we have heat, we don't have air conditioning, we have a little window one, and they've still done really well. So sometimes it's just the patience waiting for things to turn. And sometimes the leaves will get a little limp or something, but when those new leaves come, they'll be used to bark, they'll be happy. So that just happens sometimes, not all the time. So now, if you're living somewhere where it's very humid, and your pots can't dry out, you may consider bark and rock or lava rock, lots of drainage, lots of air holes, because you don't want any water sitting in there. Even styrofoam peanuts, anything to make the media inside the pot so that this moisture can travel through. And pot choices. Now, plastic pots will definitely help keep the humidity in more. And even the porcelain pots. But a clay pot will help if you're in a hotter, more humid area. A clay pot will dry out quicker because it's drying from the whole outside of the pot too, because the clay is porous if you haven't painted it. So that is going to dry out quicker. As long as you're not in an area where you're cooling down also, because the cooling down of those clay pots sometimes as the moisture's rising can actually chill your orchid. So this is why it's important for watering practices to know if you're in a very humid area, you may not have to water as often. And that's why I say throw out the bamboo stick, because you're going to be poking your orchid's roots. And I don't know, I tried it. I didn't like it. I find the bark is so easy. I tip them on their side, dump it out, look in there, see how it is, put it back. It's never hurt them. And you know for sure. Now, maybe it's 3/4 to your watering day. And you say, oh, I'm worried. Dump out that bark. Look in there. Are those roots starting to look desiccated, or are they still some plumpiness to them? Feel them. This is how you know for sure. This is the best way, the quickest way, and it really doesn't harm the plant. So, that being said, we can change the humidity by the type of pot we're using. Always remember though, you want drainage. Drainage is a must. You want the water to flow through. It's not to stay in the pot. So that is one important thing. So the fertilizing, I think I started to talk about that and wandered. The fertilizing. Now, I rinse mine quickly to get the roots wet, and then into the sink up with a little bit of the fertilizer in to soak for, today it was 5 minutes. 5 minutes. Out, fully drained, wipe off the leaves, put them back. So some people say if you soak them, if you move right to the fertilizer water mix, you could burn the roots. And some people say if you soak them too long first, before you put them in your fertilizer mix, that those roots have already absorbed all they're going to absorb, and they're not going to get the nutrient. So there's debates up there. There's some interesting talks on the internet you can read. So what I do is a quick rinse under the tap, quickly wet them, and into the fertilizer solution. That's how I do it. And during my middle of the week watering, of course, it's just straight water. So that's sort of the fertilizing debate out there. But what we want to think about most right now is in our area, unless you're in an area where you're going into a winter season, Now, then you're going to be not watering, but now you should start to look on your plants, especially if they're out on a patio or they're getting more light than in the house. All these changes signal them to grow. So next time I'm doing the patio, I could show you. They all have new leaves. They're getting new roots. They're faster ahead than these, but if I put them out in the heat out there, I'll lose my flowers. So I'm babying them. Of course, they're away from the window now. I put them all in one spot. These are all the ones in flower right now. So this is why when spring comes, you probably have to increase your watering because of all the growth happening. And that's when they need the fertilizer. Now, here's a little trick, and I haven't tried, but I'm tempted. But I read that if you put 1 tablespoon of Epsom salts in 1 gallon of water, and I might pick one plant, I haven't decided. That's all it is. You don't fertilize them the normal fertilizer that you normally do. You don't do that. You do the same watering process, but now you've got 1 tablespoon of Epsom salts in 1 gallon of water, and that's your watering for about a month. And then you go back to your normal fertilizer solution. But apparently, and I haven't tried it, that shock and fertilizer change with Epsom salts it hasn't been getting will encourage spikes. So maybe if you're not getting spikes and only do it with a healthy plant and your plant looks healthy, you could try this. And who knows, I might try it. I'm a little bit of a chicken, but I might take one plant and try it. We'll see. So I think that's all. I just wanted to make sure about everybody and their watering. And sometimes what's happening when you've changed your media is that it's already been in stress. This plant has gone from the greenhouse to the store. Who knows what's happening? So many things happen. And then, like Mother's Day, they put them in a pot with no drainage at all. They stuff a whole bunch of other plants in there, and it's just solid moss. Now, it takes a while for all that to start showing the plant. It can't live under that condition for very long. So, patience. Because this should work, but you have to make a few adjustments. If your living conditions are drier, more humid, how your situation is in your home, and whether you've got enough light, or it's nice to have a window, to have them near a window, just on a little TV tray in front of a window. They love that light, but they don't want the direct hot sun. So anyway, thank you to all my subscribers, those that have been with me for quite a while and the new ones. I'm glad to have you. This is, I'm not a professional anything. I'm just a retired grandmother. And I just want to show an easy hobby. It's so easy and so rewarding, and it gives you something else to think about. And it's like, if you're thinking about other people or if you're thinking about plants, it's all good and it all makes you feel good. So continue on with the good work, and thanks for joining me, and that's it for today.